Hello, my name is Sandeep Jauhar, and I am the author of Heart, A History, which is the PBS NewsHour New York Times Book Club Pick of the Month. PBS asked me to do a feature of my choice, and so I've decided to do a little show and tell about a coronary angiogram on a real-life patient who was recently treated at my hospital for a heart attack. I chose to do this because, as many of you who have read the book are aware, heart disease is the number one killer both in the United States and across the world. Nearly a million Americans will have a heart attack this year, and that's roughly one heart attack every 40 seconds. So many of us or someone we love will eventually be on that cath table and undergo an angiogram. And so I'd like to present some more information about it. This choice was also inspired by a reader, Connie, who wrote that she loved the book, but at times felt like she was in a lecture hall in college. So Connie, this is for you. So the case was a 52-year-old gentleman who developed crushing chest pain and went to our emergency room within about an hour or two of the onset of symptoms. And he was quickly shuttled over to the cath lab. The cath team on call was activated and brought in, and a catheterization or angiogram procedure was started. This is not a picture of the patient, but it's a very similar to what the patient must have undergone. A catheter was placed in the right wrist in the radial artery, and the catheter was then inserted through the artery, advanced up to the heart, and then engaged with the coronary arteries. Those of you who have read the book might remember this illustration, that the coronary arteries come off the beginning portion of the aorta. So the catheter actually goes up through the arms artery, the radial artery, and eventually makes its way into the aorta and engages with the coronary arteries at the beginning portion of the aorta. You might also remember that the catheter contains X-ray opaque dye, and that dye is injected into the artery, and the dye essentially flows wherever the blood flows. So if there's an obstruction and the blood stops, so does the dye. And so this is the first picture I want to show you. This is the catheter, and it's engaging in the coronary artery, and I'll start the video. And you can see here that the dye moves into the artery a couple of centimeters and then abruptly stops. So you don't have to be a cardiologist to recognize this as being very abnormal. Nature does not like discontinuities like this, and this is in fact an abrupt stoppage of blood flow in the very beginning portion of the artery. That means that all of the tissue that's served by the rest of this artery and all the branches is endangered. There's no blood flow and therefore no oxygen delivery, and the tissue will quickly die. And we have a saying in cardiology that time is muscle, and we really want to open up this obstruction as quickly as possible. How do we do that? We do it with a balloon that is blown up
and with a stent on the outside, which essentially crushes the clot and the obstruction, and essentially pushes the plaque and the clot into the wall of the artery to restore patent flow. And see here that this is the balloon being blown up, and the result of which is that blood flow resumes down the coronary artery as well as down the branches that come off the artery. Some of these branches are incredibly important. This is these branches go to some of the most critical electrical structures in the heart, and are absolutely essential for proper electrical conduction. So, just to remind, this is before. Some of you may also notice that there is a little bit of a small opacity that's further on down from the obstruction. And this is just clot that's actually filling up the artery and preventing flow. And then after the stent, that's the result, which is a patent artery, healthy blood flow, and resumption of oxygen delivery to the critical tissues. Now, what does a stent look like? I actually don't have a stent with me, but a stent is very much looks like a coil of wire in a ballpoint pen. It's just a wire that essentially gets expanded into the wall of the artery and holds it open. I mentioned in the book that we have probably overused stents. And I believe that is the case for patients with stable symptoms. But for a patient like this, who's having an acute heart attack, stents are absolutely the treatment of choice and are life-saving. So I hope you've enjoyed this this short tutorial about coronary angiography and stents and heart attacks. And hope you'll check out the book. So thanks for listening.